Hello again, Rory Nealon from Amryt Pharma is with us here at Proactive Investors Studio in London, or should I say, he's on the phone at least. Rory, great to talk to you on the phone. For investors new to what you do, give us an overview of the business, where Amryt Pharma is right now.
Thanks, Polly. Well, we're a very attractive, I would say, company that's based in the rare and orphan disease space. I guess there's three things for you to take out of the call is that firstly, we're revenue generating, so we've built a commercial, medical, and regulatory infrastructure in Europe. We've got revenue generating asset called Lojuxta, which is approved in Europe for the treatment of HoFH in adults, a rare condition. And since we've taken on that product, we've doubled the run rate since we took it on in December 2016. We are continually trying to open up new markets in Europe, as evidenced by the recent success here in the UK with the NHS. And also recent successes we've had in Saudi Arabia. So that's the first thing I'd like you to take away from this call. The second is that we'd love to replicate the success of that Lojuxta business, and we're actively out seeking to expand our commercial portfolio of leverage that infrastructure that we have in place from the Lojuxta business. And I guess the third takeaway I'd like people to get out of this, that we have a development pipeline focused on EB. EB, or epidermolysis bullosa, is a rare genetic skin disorder that leads to exceptionally fragile skin, predominantly or largely in children. And we have both a product in a phase 3 that is aiming to speed up wound healing, and we've also a preclinical gene therapy asset that uses a novel transport mechanism or non-viral vector to get collagen 7 into the cell. So we're very excited about our EB franchise, Polly.
So, Rory, loads going on, and your results out as well. Give us the headlines from that.
Yeah, well, we've grown the revenues. Like I said, we've doubled it since we in-licensed the business in December 16. If I compare the first half of 17 with the first half of 18, we've grown that Lojuxta business by 14.6%. So we're very excited about that. And that growth, like I said, has been driven by a number of factors. Namely, we have had positive negotiations with our reimbursement positions in certain jurisdictions. We've also had ongoing organic growth with individual patients being added on a country-by-country basis, and now we're starting to see the fruits of all our labours over the last number of quarters with new patients being added to new countries. So a very exciting first half of the year.
And I see you've announced that extended patent runway to take you right through to 2028. What's the detail on that?
Sure. So the product, the commercial asset that we have is called Lojuxta, and that product had a, I guess, what's called data exclusivity, which gives you exclusivity in the condition in question out to 2024, the early 2024. That was also supported by various patents that are in place until 2025, and those patents have now been extended in the vast majority of European jurisdictions. I would note, with the exception of the UK, we're hopeful that's on its way, but we haven't got it yet. And that has extended the patent runway out till the middle of 2028. So that's prolonged the life of this revenue-generating asset significantly.
And I see a milestone coming up for you as well in Q4, late on in Q4. Give us some detail on that as well.
Sure. So this is, as I alluded to a minute ago, this is our development asset in EB, epidermolysis bullosa. The product is called AP101. And that product has already been approved in Europe for the treatment of partial thickness wounds in adults. EB is also a partial thickness wound, but now we're doing a final or pivotal phase 3 study in EB specifically, which is an orphan indication or rare disease. And we will have the layman's version of it is we'll have a halfway look-see at the data halfway through the study in December of this year. What happens is the first half of the patients in the study, the data will be sent to an independent statistician, and that statistician will get the unblinded look at the data. So they will see active versus placebo, and they'll come back to us with one of three options. They'll say, keep going in your study, everything's going great, or keep going but add X more patients, whatever X would be, to maintain what's called statistical power in the study, or they may say stop for futility, you're wasting your time. We're obviously hopeful it's option one or option two, and that's going to be a very significant milestone at the back end of this year for investors, because it'll result in hopefully a significant valuation uplift for shareholders.
Rory, if I'm talking to you in a year from now, where's the company?
Good question. So obviously I've said to you, you know, on the Lojuxta commercial revenue piece of the business, we've doubled the business since we've been licensed it. We'd like to see that if for 2019 we'll be close to a tripling of that business from what it was when we in-licensed this in December 2016. So that's the first thing to look out for in New Year's time in terms of the commercial asset. On the development side, there'll be three significant milestones. And these are all big value-generating events for shareholders. The first will probably be on our gene therapy asset. So we're looking to show equivalence to comparable products that are in development in the States, with, that have significant valuations, as it turns out. And we're hoping to show that data, which will show that we're depositing the gene, the collagen 7, in the right place, and that it's doing its job. So in the case of EB, what it's doing is it's acting like Velcro. It's dropping out what are called anchoring fibrils to show that the skin, the two layers of the skin, are being pulled together. We're hoping to show that data in this preclinical asset in quarter 4 this year. The second significant milestone I've already spoken about, Polly, which is the unblinded interim efficacy analysis, where this independent statistician gets to look at the data and compare placebo versus active. And then the third significant milestone, assuming number two is positive, will be hopefully the completion of that study, so that what's called top-line data at the back end of Q2 next year. So there are three significant value-generating milestone events to keep an eye out on the development side of the business.
You sound like a very busy man. I'll leave you to get on with it for the moment. Rory Nealon, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you, Polly.